We've given the type to lambda expressions that produce functions, but we haven't called any functions yet. So, should we give a type to this expression? Here I've got this lambda, but because I've got left at the beginning, that means I'm applying that lambda to the argument true. And this lambda, as we've seen, has type bool arrow num, because we can show that through our tree before. And the argument here, true, well, clearly that has type bool. So should we give a type to this application? We're going to say yes, because this type bool matches up with the left-hand side of the arrow. So because of that, we're going to give this expression overall the type number. That is, because the argument matches the left-hand side of the arrow, the overall application has the type of the right-hand side of the arrow. The constraint, then, is that there is an arrow here for the function part, and that the argument matches up with it. If we try this example, we have our same lambda, which has type bool arrow num. We have a 5 here, which has type num. This num does not match the left of the arrow, and so we have no type for this application. Or, if we have 7 applied to 5, the reason we reject this is because 7 has type num, 5 has type num, but there's no arrow over here to match up. So since there's no arrow, it's not going to be okay, and we will say that expression has no type. Here is the general rule, then. If you've got an application of E1 applied to E2, and you get a type for E1, it has to be an arrow type. It can be any tau2 and tau3, any argument and result types, as long as E2 also has a type, and it has type tau2, which is the same type as the left-hand side of the arrow. In that case, the tau3 from the right-hand side of the arrow, that is the type of the argument of the application expression. So using that rule is how we get that lambda x if x12 applied to true is of type number, right? Because we get an arrow type for the function position, we get a boolean for the argument position, bool matches up, and so we take this number down as the result of type check. On the other hand, when we use this variant where we replace true by 5, 5 has type num, this num as tau2 does not match this bool as type 2,2, so it's not matching the pattern, so we have no type. And of course, when we have 7 applied to 5, there's not even an arrow as the result of the recursive call, so we can't use that rule to give it a type.